Hello, welcome to the CheckMK channel. Today, we'll show you how you can monitor OpenShift clusters with CheckMK. OpenShift is a Kubernetes distribution by Red Hat. With CheckMK, you can monitor the health and the performance of the cluster itself, the infrastructure, and the workload of the OpenShift cluster. Let's take a look how you can configure that with CheckMK. Our journey starts with the official CheckMK user guide. Here we will find all steps required to set up OpenShift monitoring. Let's search for the OpenShift article. And in this article, we will learn about specifically the prerequisites in the cluster which we have to create. Among them, the first one is we have to create a namespace. Let's just copy the command and run it in our shell. We've created a namespace CheckMK monitoring. The next thing we do is we will apply this YAML file to our cluster. And before we do it, I always recommend taking a look into it so that you don't install something weird into your system. So the YAML file specifies a service account, a cluster role, and a cluster role binding. The cluster role, you can see what access CheckMK will get into your cluster. It will be able to see these resources and see details on these resources. So very limited set of rights it has, so it's quite safe to implement that. Let's run this. And we can now see that we have created a service account, a cluster role, and a cluster role binding. Now we have the requirements on that part. Next thing is we need to understand where is the API endpoint which we need to monitor the cluster. For this, we can use the command cluster info, which will tell us that the Kubernetes control plane is running at this address. We'll need this later in the configuration of CheckMK. Next thing is what we need is the Prometheus endpoint, because what we do with CheckMK is we query the Kubernetes API, but also the Prometheus API endpoint to get all the data required for monitoring OpenShift. Here we can see it. This is the endpoint which we need to configure later on. Lastly, we need to get a token to ensure that we have secure communications and that we are the ones allowed to actually communicate to the API. We can run this command and we will get this token, save it for later as well. And lastly, we can get the certificate. In this case, I will jump over that step. I recommend, however, in production environments to get the certificate and apply it to ensure that you have secure communications with the cluster. As the next step, we have to set up our CheckMK monitoring. You can also follow the guidelines in here, but as we don't have to copy any commands anymore, I will just move directly into CheckMK. We are now in CheckMK, and the first thing we save the passwords of the token in our password store, so that we can reuse them later on in a safe fashion. We can add a password. I call it my OpenShift cluster. And I go back to the command line and copy this token. Now it's saved in our password store. The next thing what we do is we create a host. And this is a host where all the data will be stored from the OpenShift cluster and which will query the OpenShift cluster. Let's call it OpenShift cluster. And we don't have to assign an IP address to it. You can just leave it like that and just save it and view the folder. As the next piece, we configure the connection. For that, we go on the setup to VM Cloud Container and then to Kubernetes. We add a rule I call this OpenShift. I use the comment function to tell that I created that as the CMK admin. In this next step, I specify the cluster. Here in this case, it's my OpenShift test cluster, OpenShift test. I use from the password store the token, and now I have to enter the API server connection. For that, I go back to my console, and here you can see this is what I copied before. Copy this over and can paste it here. Next, I choose to enrich the usage data with data from OpenShift. So you have to select in the drop-down box this option, and then we can specify the Prometheus API endpoint. And this is the one which we have in here. So also copy it over and save it in here. I leave the standard options in here. You can also decide to monitor specific namespaces to ensure that the cluster resource aggregation, this means basically which data is included in the available resources in your cluster. You can specify that. Typically, don't have to do it. And you can also decide to import annotations so that you can use them later on in host labels and CheckMK rules. Also not do it in this case, but it's a powerful option. Lastly, we have to assign this rule to the OpenShift cluster so that CheckMK knows that this host will query the data from the OpenShift environment. As a last step, we configure the dynamic host management. We add a new connection, we call it OpenShift. Also call it OpenShift again. We use the connector type piggyback data and we restrict the source host to the OpenShift cluster to ensure that only that host is being used. Then we use the standard sync interval of 1 minute and leaves the standard options. We also decide that we delete hosts without piggyback data. That means if a pod vanishes from OpenShift or an application vanishes from OpenShift, this also vanishes from the monitoring. With ephemeral workloads like OpenShift, this is a useful option because you don't want that applications still being monitored. We save it. And now we just have to activate the changes. And with that, we can now take a look into our OpenShift host. Let's rerun it, see if the connection works. And we can see we were able to connect to it. And CheckMK discovered a lot of services on it. And so we can now basically run the service discovery, run service discovery. And CheckMK immediately discovers the basic information on the cluster here. We can see them under underside services. Have we been able to successfully query the data from Prometheus, the CPU resources on the cluster, how the requests are utilized, if the API is available and ready, how the memory is being consumed on the cluster, how many nodes we have. You can see it's a very small cluster, and how many pods are running. Let's accept these changes. Activate the changes again. And with that, we have set up our OpenShift monitoring. CheckMK provides out-of-the-box dashboards for Kubernetes, which you'll find in the monitor menu under Applications under Kubernetes. You can see here our OpenShift test cluster. We'll have to wait a little bit until the data is populated, typically 1 or 2 minutes, then we'll have sufficient data so that every dashlet is displayed. So our OpenShift monitoring has started to gather data. We can see the OpenShift test cluster, which we just configured previously. We can see the CPU resources being consumed in the cluster and the memory resources, how many pods are running, how many worker nodes we have, also some more meta information like the version of our OpenShift cluster And if you would configure more clusters, they would all show up in here, and you would also see more detailed information on the graphs on the right side. Let's take a look at the individual cluster, and you can go into a more detailed dashboard by clicking on the name of the cluster. And then you will get in a detailed dashboard. Let's zoom out a little bit so that we can see everything. And we will be able to see all relevant metrics directly in one view. We can see the daemon sets, the stateful sets, and the deployments running on your system. You can see which ones, for example, consume the least amount of memory. We can also see which are consume the most amount of memory. We can see how the cluster is utilized. And you can see the metrics are being gathered. And the longer you will have it running, the more information you will, of course, then have. We can also see cluster problems. You can here see that there is a problem with a container installer application running in a pod for the kubectl manager. We can also see that a deployment of the OpenShift console only has 1 out of 2 ready pods. And we can see that a pod of exactly these things is running into an error. And we can then look into further details once we move further down in our dashboards. Moving further down is quite easy. You can just, for example, select, hey, let's take a look at the API server deployment. And then you will get a deployment dashboard, which provides you details about all the pods running of this deployment. Yeah. You can see the usage, the memory usage, and we can then also, if we want to do so, further dive into a specific pod and see details on that. For example, the condition, the containers, you have in this case 2 containers running in it, you can see which images are being used, and we can see some meta information, the phase they're running, how many restarts they had in the last hour and in total, and how long this is up now. That's the OpenShift monitoring with CheckMK. So when you want to dive deeper into it, just go onto the Kubernetes menu entry in the applications, and you will have an overview over all your OpenShift clusters. That was OpenShift monitoring with CheckMK. With just a few steps, we were able to configure the monitoring and were able to get full visibility into the entire cluster, from the top level to the very detailed level of the pods. CheckMK does all this without a lot of effort on your OpenShift cluster. So we don't install any workloads on it. We gather the data via the Kubernetes API and the Prometheus endpoints, and with that, and provide a very secure way how to monitor OpenShift clusters. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon again.